Good evening, Mayor and Council. Midori Lichtwardt, Assistant City Manager. We've got the slide up here. I'm going to give you a brief COVID update. And could I have the video, please?
Thank you, Mayor Lincoln, for this opportunity to share recent data on COVID-19 and to talk about some trends we might be seeing in the future. San Joaquin County is currently experiencing a spike in COVID-19 cases. This wave began in early July as the Delta variant became the predominant circulating strain of the coronavirus. While other areas of the state might be starting to see their numbers stabilize, we continue to see rising case rates and hospitalization numbers here in Stockton and countywide. Our current daily numbers of confirmed positive cases and the number of people admitted to hospitals for COVID-19 now surpass the peak numbers we had during the wave of summer 2020. We knew that this surge might be as bad as last summer's, but we've passed last summer's numbers and still haven't reached the peak of this current surge. More than half of our ICU beds are occupied by COVID patients, and our ICU bed capacity use is at 136%. ICU bed availability is now below 10% for the San Joaquin Valley region. In addition, I want to bring attention to one concerning trend. We are seeing dramatic increases in case rates, particularly for our younger age groups, 0 to 4 and school-aged children. This is all the more reason for parents and caregivers of young children to get vaccinated. Vaccinating anyone eligible in a household, 12 years of age or older, adds protection to those who are younger or immunocompromised in the home. No one can say with certainty what will happen next in the progression of COVID-19 or its effect on our communities, but we can reflect on what has happened and look at what we're currently seeing as a precursor to what we might expect. We believe that COVID will become endemic, that we will not eradicate it, but like the seasonal flu, we'll learn to manage it, eventually resuming our pre-COVID lives. But until this happens, we will see more variants over time. The Delta variant accounted for 95% of cases in the month of July, and so far, all of the sequenced cases resulting for the month of August. We need to look now at the future, at the next variant, and prepare as best we can. Remember, we are in a race against variants. We are already looking at the need to give boosters to vaccinated individuals and planning now to make sure people get that added protection. We also foresee that the medical community and our community at large will have to address the issue of long COVID, where some individuals continue to experience lingering and often debilitating COVID symptoms. So our work will not be done, but we will get through this very hard part of COVID together. Let's continue to care for one another by masking, washing our hands, getting tested and staying home when sick, and by getting vaccinated. Vaccinations take place right here at the Stribley Center, and appointments can be made on myturn.ca.gov.
Okay, it's not letting me go to the next slide. Marcel, are you able to help? Thank you. So that was just a quick excerpt of the joint press conference put on by Dr. Maggie Park from the San Joaquin County Public Health Services and the City of Stockton. And here you've got some, you've seen these slides before. I'll just go quickly. San Joaquin County numbers, total confirmed cases, 89,293, and total deaths, 1,548, 60 since the last update we did about a month ago. The county is also reporting 9,387 total cases and 93 deaths in Tracy since the start of the pandemic. And, due to the Labor Day holiday, the most recent data available from San Joaquin County Public Health Services was from their September 3rd report, which reflects data through September 2nd, the same day of that press conference we just saw. Recovery information that was included in older reports from the county has since been phased out as the county felt that the information was a bit simplistic, and it was defined as 21 days after the episode date. On June 15th, when we held our first in-person public meeting since the beginning of the pandemic, San Joaquin County's daily case rate per 100,000 was 3.3 with a positivity rate of 1.7. We reopened our city facility to the public the following day. When we last provided an update to you on August 17th, our county case rate was 30.2. The state is reporting it to be state is reporting it to be 41 today with a positivity test rate of 7.3. This is some new information. Just wanted to provide some context for the council in terms of COVID-19 and how it continues to impact your essential workers. Since the pandemic started, 75 city employees have reported testing positive for COVID-19, and we've reported two outbreaks as defined by Cal OSHA since the beginning of the pandemic. California Department of Health defines an outbreak as three or more laboratory-confirmed cases of COVID-19 among employees who live in different households within a two-week period. In just the last month, there have been at least 16 positive cases among our employees, with 42 employees reporting COVID-19 exposures. This is just a quick slide on some of the updated quarantine guidance that you probably have seen, vaccinated versus unvaccinated. And we provide this just to remind council that we, as your city employees, have to function under Cal OSHA rules that are sometimes different than what you may see out in the general public from coming down from the state. State public health orders, masks are required for unvaccinated people and recommended for everyone indoors in indoor public settings. And some of the new information is vaccinations for healthcare workers. It requires workers in healthcare settings to be fully vaccinated or receive their second dose by September 30th, 2021. And then also Medi-Cal vaccination incentives. There's $350 million in incentive payments to help close the vaccination gap between Medi-Cal beneficiaries and Californians as a whole, significantly stepping up outreach in underserved communities. Since first implementing these measures on July 26, California has administered nearly 1 million new first doses. A couple of changes that can affect some facilities here at the city, in particular the Grand Theater. Definition of mega events. Currently, verification of being vaccinated or a pre-entry negative test is necessary where there are 5,000 or more persons at an indoor event. Right now, that doesn't really apply to us, but beginning September 20th, proof of vaccination or a negative COVID test will be required for indoor events with 1,000 or more attending. Our Grand Theater has just about a capacity of just under 600, so if they lowered any more, we might be affected by that. In partnership with the private sector, this new measure will help encourage more vaccinations and increase safety at events while ensuring businesses can thrive. Beyond dropping the requirement from 5,000 to 1,000 individual, self-attestation to verify a person's vaccination status will no longer be accepted. These changes will remain in place until November 1st. As I mentioned, this update will not impact events held at the Grand Theater at this time, as our capacity is under 1,000. Here is the slide that will talk to you a little bit about some resources. You can now get a digital copy of your COVID-19 vaccination card. Follow the address on the yellow box there. You can also protect yourself and your family by signing up for exposure notifications. If you've been exposed to COVID-19, you'll get an alert and additional information on testing and next steps at calnotify.gov. Here's some vaccination information by jurisdiction. Statistics show that 77.3% of eligible Tracy residents are fully vaccinated. We have the third highest vaccination rate in the county. As a reminder, everyone 12 years old or older is eligible to get a COVID vaccination, and vaccinations are provided. Are provided free of charge. You may be asked to provide your medical insurance card, but that if your insurance does not pay for the COVID vaccination, you will not be charged. Here's some more resources. San Joaquin County is now accepting applications for the Family COVID Assistance Grant Program. Eligible residents can qualify for up to $10,000 for rent, mortgage, and utility costs due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Also, San Joaquin County will provide up to $100,000 for eligible San Joaquin County businesses that have been negatively impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. Again, this is a county program, and you can learn more about it by going to sjgov.org, COVID-19 grants. A reminder of current testing opportunities in Tracy. So the West Valley Mall is currently doing testing from 9 to 4:30. There are some other local testings being done by, and you can find out those locations, projectbaseline.com. At the time of reopening, the state planned to assess conditions by September 1, 2021, to determine whether updated requirements or recommendations are needed beyond October 1st of 2021. We will continue to closely monitor new developments at the national, state, and local level and provide updates as they become available. And that concludes my report.